Hey everybody, this is Kennedy Hawk. We are back with another Card of the Day video. This time we're going to talk all about Star-Lord Ally. So the Star-Lord Ally card is a basic ally from the Venom Hero Pack. Don't let his low cost fool you. He gives you an encounter card when played, which is super thematic, but often the cost of this does not offset itself with a reward. So Star-Lord is 2 cost, unique ally Star-Lord Peter Quill. 2 thwart, 2 attack with a star. The star is that Star-Lord's attacks gain ranged, so he doesn't take damage from retaliate. It's okay. He has the Guardian trait, and he's not trait locked like all the other Guardian basic allies, so that's appreciated. And he has 3 health. Usually a 2-cost ally is something that I would say just chump into every deck that exists. But that's not the case with Star-Lord because of his forced response. After Star-Lord enters play under your control, deal yourself 1 face-down encounter card. Now you're not going to resolve that card right away. Just like any dealt encounter card, you're going to wait until the end of the villain phase to deal with that. So he can be a very good closer, but I hate including cards in my deck that are cards that are sort of win more. They're cards that really help me when I'm already at the cusp of winning. I'd rather include cards that are going to help me claw my back away from defeat, and I don't think Star-Lord is one of those cards. That being said, never underestimate a chump block. 3 true cost for 4 damage in a block is okay, but that encounter card, it adds so much cost to this character that I'm not super wild about him. Let's look at some cards that combo with Star-Lord Ally really well. Obviously, it's going to be the Guardians package, so we're looking at Nowhere, because that'll draw you a card when you play him. Pumping him up with Energy Spear or using Target Practice and Laser Blaster to really make his attacks go crazy. You could even use Comms Implants to get him up to 3 thwarts, but at the same time, there's so many better Guardians allies you could do this with. That being said, all those Guardians allies are trait locked, so without shenanigans like Make the Call or a Guardian character yourself, you're going to struggle to play them. I have seen some edge cases where I've included him in a Thor deck because I want more encounter cards as I'm searching for minions to draw cards. That being said, it could be really hard to deal with an extra encounter card if it's not a minion, or if it's 2 minions, that doesn't help you draw extra cards, so you're living on that risk-reward, like, ragged edge doing that. So Star-Lord, not my favorite ally. Still a very efficient ally, like, resource cost-wise, but the amount of resources you're going to pay to deal with that encounter card often makes me not include him in decks. Alright. So, like I said, we're going to end each of these Card of the Day videos with a bad to busted card quality scale. So, where do we think Star-Lord is going to fall? Is he going to be bad? Is he going to be busted? Or is he going to be B tier? And I think everyone here knows the answer. He is going to be bad. This is a card that I would not recommend you include in your deck unless you have a dire circumstance that makes it so whatever cost he's providing is something that's going to benefit you. If you're playing against a villain with a bunch of extra attacks and you're Spider-Man, maybe that makes sense. Or if you're playing a Guardians deck and you need to get 6 wide in Guardians and there's no other way to do it, which is impossible in all the aspects at this point, maybe you do it because those are the only cards you have available because you've built another deck or something. But for the most part, Star-Lord Ally, unfortunately, a bad card. So we will be back tomorrow with another Card of the Day video talking about an aggression card from the Guardian cycle.